It's Good Will Wednesday. There you go.
Yeah.
It's Good Will Wednesday, and our topic today is back to school healthy lunches and snacks. And we have Mr. Robert Ferguson, who's a certified nutritionist. He's written a book called Diet Free for Life. He's worked with such stars as Shaka, Chuck D, Toni Braxton, LaToya, and many more to lose weight. Robert Ferguson, let's vet you first. Have you ever had a weight problem?
I sure did have a weight problem.
Okay.
Yes, 100%.
As a child?
And why did that happen?
Well, you know what? It sneaks up on everybody.
That's true.
Sneak it up on me.
It sneaks up on you, and then you got to do something about it. And nobody wants to battle it when you got to give up that mac and cheese.
You ain't lying.
All right.
So you determined a methodology for yourself that works now for others?
Well, not just for myself, but actually worked for my mom. That was my first pupil, and she went on to lose about 125 pounds.
Wow.
And so, you know, if it works for mom, then you share it with the world. So it's definitely mama approved.
All right, back to school. Let's talk about healthy lunches and snacks that you send your kids back to school with. All right, what's a healthy snack or lunch that's delicious?
Right, that's the key word, delicious.
and that's a tough one because kids are picky eaters no matter what. But if you can get some fruit in there, apple, pear, you know, banana, those things are always healthy. And then, you know, give them the food that they want, because if you don't give them food they want, they're going to eat it anyway.
They want candy.
Yes, and so if you're going to give them some candy, just balance it out. You know, fruits, throw in some things that we all know are healthier, like carrots, but dip it in some type of dressing that makes it good, like ranch. But the challenge is just balancing it out, because kids are going to eat what they're going to eat.
And if they don't want to eat it, how do we make them eat it?
Well, sometimes you can't make them. I mean, there's some kids these days that'll stand up and put the knuckles up.
Right.
then that's when we use our exercise that we've had and knock them out. Right.
Right.
Exactly.
Okay. Well, so give me an example of a healthy snack that you can send your kid to school with.
Well, again, apple, banana, fruits are good. Crackers, cheese, those are good. Throw those in there. You know, have them eat the foods that they're going to take to school are the same foods they're eating throughout the week and the weekend. So it really does come down to what parents are eating. You know, it's like there's a stat that says if one parent is overweight or obese, the kid is 40% likely to be overweight or obese as an adult. And if both parents are battling with their weight, the kid is 80% likely to battle with their weight as an adult. So I think it really comes down to us parents just kind of eating the foods that we like to eat that's helping us. Then the kids will—they'll do what they see us do instead of what we tell them to do.
And so modeling is probably what I'm hearing you say,
right.
and we have to start it, and then our children pick up on it, and if they're not eating what we're eating, they're just SOL.
Well, I mean, kids are going to sneak out. I mean, you have the strictest parents in the world who have their kids eating everything close to cardboard as possible, but the reality is, kids are going to meet other kids. They're going to be curious about drinking that soda. And so instead of, like, having them be curious and go out and start eating foods behind your back, then show them how to eat those foods in a way where they're not overindulging. So a little bit of something is fine. It's just that we overindulge at times, and that's the big challenge.
And as a parent, you said, if the parent is overindulging, then don't expect the kid to not overindulge because the parents are, right? Is that what you're saying?
That's exactly what I'm saying. It kind of goes back to that old, you know, saying or belief that we had back in the day. It's like, do as I say, not as I do, right? That doesn't work.
Yeah.
You know, kids are going to do what they're going to do, but if you surround them, like, always have fruits and vegetables in the house if possible. When you snack, don't eat the whole bag, but if you're going to have some chips, have some chips. Just show them that you don't have to overindulge, and that really goes a long way, not just as kids, but when they grow up and become adults.
And we should read the labels when we are packing these snacks and see how much sodium and sugar or sugar substitutes are in the
And processed foods.
And processed foods.
Yeah, I mean, you have like a challenge with processed foods. Now they have this thing called ultra processed foods. When you're eating a snack, no matter what it is, from a caloric standpoint, if you look at the label, keep it to no more than 200 calories. And if you just do that, you make a extremely positive impact on how it impacts their energy throughout the day. And it puts them in a habit, again, where their portions are always part of the solution. Mm. So 200 calories, and I would say when it comes to sodium, it's not that big of a deal if you're keeping the calories around that, but make sure it doesn't have more than 350 milligrams of sodium in a snack. And that right there, I'm telling you, it works masters. It teaches a person exactly what to eat. And if they don't know exactly what to eat, that's considered healthy. Because they're conscious of the label and how many calories they're consuming at that time, it'll help them choose wisely.
Okay. All right. Questions for the coach, Robert Ferguson, at 646464. Do you have kids?
I do. I got a 9 and 11-year-old, two daughters.
And how they doing?
Yeah.
Hey, it's a challenge, even from the coach. But you know what? You do the best you can. And again, I know they're always watching me. And so as they're maturing in life, I'm seeing that actually is playing out.
All right. 646464. If you have a question about snacks for the kids, our nutritionist, Robert Ferguson, will be around to the bottom of the next hour.